Okay, so I am making a video on that handout I gave you, but I'm not going to do all questions. So I'm going to just select a few that are a little bit more challenging. So, especially with the fraction ones. So I'm going to start with number 4, because number 3 really. So number 4, negative 3 plus a half. My pen's not working. Hang on. Okay, here we go. So negative 3 plus a half. Now, I wouldn't normally do this, but just I guess if you want to make, if it's easier for you to see it, you can put this over 1, right? The answer is negative 2.5, right? Because if you have negative 3 and you take 0.5 away from it, you're going to have 2.5 left. But if I put it on as a fraction, and if you want to, I guess if it's easier for you to see it this way, so I'm going to... The common denominator is 2, so that's going to become a 2 here, negative, right? Plus, and this is a 2. So this is already a 2, so there's no changes here. But that 1 became a 2, and how did that happen? It was times 2, and multiply times 2 on top. So 3 times 2 on top is 6. So we get, so in a way, because the denominators are the same, so that 2 stays here. And just focus on the top. On the top, you got negative 6 plus 1. Well, if you ask yourself, can I make 0 pairs? I can. Right, with 1 negative and 1 positive, and then how many negatives will I have left over? I'm gonna have negative 5. So now if you think about how does this become this, this is an improper fraction. How many times can 2 go into 5? You can go into 5 2 times. How many left over? 1 over 2. I'll put that. And if you want to change the half into a decimal, you get negative 2.5. So that's how I would have done it. Number 5, which is the one next to it, again, this one is much easier because the denominator is already the same, so that's a 9. Now focus on this, so I'm just going to write negative 2 over here plus 3. So ignore the denominators for a second. I have to find the value. And again, if you think of 0 pairs, I can get 1 negative with 1 positive, and then a negative with another positive, and I end up having 1 left over. Or in a more descriptive way, you know, if you look at negative 2, and negative 3, you know that these guys are going to win, right? Because how many more do they have? 1. And what team is that winning team on? It's the positive. So that's why, that's the reason why it becomes 1 over 9. Next one is decimals. So again, the past week, for the past week and a half or so, we've been working on a negative plus a negative, multiplying negatives, multiplying when the signs are different, adding when the signs are different. So the integer rules apply to this, right? So again, when we added a negative number plus a negative number, what do we know? Well, they're all friends, so it's just going to be negative, right? And likewise, it's the same rules, except that now it's decimals and fractions, but the same rules apply. So I know my answer is going to be negative, nobody, right? So I can't make 0 pairs, they're all friendlies here. So it's just a matter of how many negatives will I have. So I have 3.5, 4.9. If I add that, that's a 14, bring the decimal, goes 1. I got 8.4, but make sure you make that they are on the negative side. Okay. I guess I'm doing quite a few. So let's work on this one. So again, these two are negatives, so it's a negative and a negative. No, there's no... Can't make 0 pairs. In other words, they're friendly, so I know my answer is going to be negative. So I would, if I were you, change this whole thing to an improper fraction. So 4 times 2 is 8 plus 1, so this becomes 9 over 4. Negative, by the way. Plus, and on this side, 4 times 3 is 12 plus 1 is 13 over 4, but negative. So when we add fractions, we know what the denominators are the same, so that stays. I'm going to put a negative already because I already know. And then focus on the top. So it's negative 9 and negative 13 friendlies. Add them up. 9 and 13 gives you negative 22 over 4. You can simplify if you wish. Okay, so I will. That's going to give me 4 goes in. It's going to be negative, first of all. 4 goes 22 5 times. I have 2 left over. 2 over 4, if you want to simplify even further, it's negative 5 and a half. That's okay. Here, decimals, likewise. So this is the same thing, same idea as number 8. When they're adding, they're both negative, so they're both friendly. So the answer is going to be negative. So we got to add 0.6 and 2.5, and that gives me 3.1. Number nine. Denominators are the same. So, but I know. Well, let me skip it. This is going to be negative something. I change my denominator. The common denominator is 20. And how did that 4 become a 20? It was times 5, which means I multiply the top by 5, so I get 15 here. How did that 5 become a 20, right? So it's times 4, so the top is times 4. So an equivalent fraction. So instead of saying 3/4, we're going to say 15 over 20. Instead of saying 1/5, we're going to say 4 over 20. The same thing, right? We're creating equivalent fractions with so that it's easier for us to add and subtract. So again, 20 is going to go here because the denominator is the same. It's negative 15 and positive 4. So let me just pull that out. Negative 15, right? And 4. So concentrate on the numerators. Negative 15 and 4. Who's going to win? These guys are going to win. Why? Because they have more. That's a 5, by the way. And negative 15 plus 4. Well, after you make 0 pairs, you're going to have a bunch of negatives left over. And how many negatives left over are you going to have? Negative 1. Please, when you're doing problems that have more than one operation, follow order of operations. So in this case, we're going to do these two first. It's 3 plus negative 75. Well, if you look at it, who's going to win? The negative. So I know my answer is going to be negative. Why do they win? Because they have more. How many more? Let me find out. So I'm going to subtract both numbers, 7.5 minus 3. And 7 minus 3 is 4. So that's the answer to that two. And then now I'm going to add 1.2. Well, if you look at this, it's a negative plus a positive. They're not friends, so they're going to have a little quarrel over here. Who's going to win the negatives? It's clear that there's more negatives, right? So if you make 0 pairs, you're going to have a bunch of negatives left over. So what's the difference between 4.5 and 1.2? We need to subtract. So 4.5 minus 1.2, that's a 3. 3.3 negative. Okay. Let me see how much. I don't want to do everything for you. Okay, so I'll skip around. I can just do them all. Here, same thing. Negative 1.32 plus 502. I'm going to do these two first. If you think of these two, who's going to win? Well, there's definitely more positive. So I know my answer is going to be positive. It's just a matter of how much. So 5.02, 1.32. If I subtract, I'm going to do some borrowing over here. That becomes a 10, so that's a 0. 10 minus 3 is 7. 4 minus 1 is 3. So, but again, it's a positive because there's more positive. So 3.70, 70, plus negative 1.24. So now, we have a positive and a negative. Again, they're not friends, so it's going to win the positives. Why? Because there's more. So 3.7 minus 1.24, right? Let me subtract that. Some borrowing again. 10 minus 4 is 6. 6 minus 2 is 4, and 3 minus 0. So final answer, 2.46, but positive. I don't remember which one. Okay, so 12. Again, I'm going to add these two. There's two negatives coming together. So we're just going to be further to the left of the number line, right? Because we're adding a negative plus a negative negative. So we're moving towards the left. Negative 3 plus negative 1.35 is negative 4.35, which I'm then now going to add to 2.5. So I'm going to add, so this became that, and I'm going to add that. Now again, if you look at it, you can clearly tell that the negatives are going to win, right? Negative 4.35 plus 2.5. Why? Because there's more. How many more? Not too much, but still more. So let's subtract. 13 minus 5 is 8, and 3 minus 2 is 1. And I get negative 1. Where am I? Number 13. So number 13, can I get some separation between these? I can. Look at that. So these two, again, I'm adding these two. I'm going to get a positive number. That's very easy. And sorry, I'm adding these two. It's going to be negative, right? So it's a negative plus a negative. They're all friends. But that's just going to, I can do that in my head. Negative 6.65 plus negative 0.2. And again, they're just two negatives being added together, so that means we're moving further to the left of the number line, and that's just going to give us 6.25. Here you have a choice. Well, not a choice. Let's just put everything to the common denominator, which in this case will be 8. Everything's going to be 8. The last one's already an 8th, so we don't have to worry. So how does the 4 here become an 8 times 2? So, which means I multiply the top by 2, I get 14. How did the 2 become an 8 times 4? Which means I multiply the top by 4, which gives me 3 times 4 is 12. Now I can very clear. So I know it's going to be 8 at the bottom, and I'm just going to sort of bring negative 12, just the numerators to the top. And that's what you should focus on, because the denominator is not much to do. So let's do this right here first. Negative 12 minus 14 becomes negative 12 plus negative 14. Negative 12 plus negative 14 is negative 26, right, because they're both negative. And then we're going to add that plus 1. Now it's a little tiny fight, and you've got negative 25 left over. You can change it to a mixed number. I'm not going to bother. Fractions. Okay, so this is the one we're doing. All right, so let's do fractions. There's nothing to this. I really just hope that you guys can change it to a mixed number. I think it an improper fraction, I'm sorry. It just makes life so much easier. So I'm going to do this on top. 4 times 3 is 12. This is really 13 over 4. Plus, put in parentheses, 2 times 1 is 2, so that's negative 3 over 2. And the last one, 4 times 2 is 8, so that's 9 over 4. The only change I'm going to make is this fraction over here, because it's not into fourths, right? So I keep this, 13 over 4, plus, I change this into 4. So 2 times 2, so that means the top is times 2, so 6, plus 9 over 4. Good! My denominator is a 4, I just don't know what my numerator is. So let me write my numerator. So it's a 13 plus negative 6 plus 9. These two added, positives are going to win, so I get 7 left over. And then I'm going to add the 9 in the corner, so it's going to give me 16. So it's going to be 16 positive, actually, plus 4, which 16 divided by 4 is just simply 4. So that's your final answer. Likewise here, I'm going to change this to a mixed number, an improper fraction, so that's become 18 over 5 plus 9, it's 13, negative 13 over 9, and the last one is 1 over 5. I'm actually going to add these two together. First, I'm just going to move them around. So I can add those two, and that becomes 19 over 5. And now I'm going to add that to negative 13 over 9. So if I find a common denominator, it's 45, right? How did the 5 become 45 times 9? So I'm going to multiply the top times 9. 9 times 9 is 81. Go 8, 171. And then this one is, how did the 9 become 45 times 5? It's going to give me 60, 15, carrying the 1, 65, negative 65. Okay, ready to add. It's 171 over 45 plus negative 65, 45. So this is going to be, well, there's more positives, right? So I know the bottom is going to be 45. So if you focus on the top, it gets negative, 171 plus negative 65. More positives? For sure, right? So subtract. 171 minus 65, 11 minus 5 is 6. 0, 106, positive 106 over 45, which you can change to a mixed number, but if you got that far, you're fine. Same thing here. Is there a, why do they do that? So the common denominator here would be 45. So I'm going to change. The first thing I'm going to do is go 5 times 8, which is 40, plus 3 is 43 over 5, minus 1 over 15. So I changed that mixed number to an improper fraction. Now I'm going to put everything over 45. All right, put a minus here. And then how did the 9 become 45? It's times 5, so the top is times 5. How did the 5 become a 9? Times 5, so I'm going to multiply the 9. The top times 9 is 27, 36, 38. And 15 times 3 is 45, so multiply the top by 3. So it becomes just 3. Let's do these two first. If I do those two first, I'm going to, well, there's more positives, right? So it's going to be 45. And then It's negative 5 here plus 387. Well, the 387 is definitely going to win. It's going to win because they have 382 more. And then finally, I'm going to do minus 3 over 45, and that becomes very simple. 45 at the bottom. 382 minus 3 is 370. And again, you can change it to a what do you call it, improper, and you should be okay. I'm going to do just one or two more over here because the rest is pretty simple. Let's do one with number 10 here. For number 10, let's focus on these two. It's a negative plus a negative, so they're all friends. You're just gonna have to add 3.24 and 1.55. It's gonna give you 4.79 bit or negative. And then we're going to add plus 2.512. You definitely know that the negatives are going to win because there's more of them, so let's subtract them. It's 4.79 minus 2.512. Very important that you line them up. There is no, remember in this empty space here, we can add a zero. Some borrowing here. We're going to borrow just from here. It becomes a 10, becomes an 8, a 7, a 2, and a 2. And so 4.79 negative plus 2.512 ends up as 2.278, which is, just make sure that it's a negative number. The rest really, really, really simple, but I'm gonna focus on these. So you were asked, so today we talked about what a rational number is. A rational number is any number that can be expressed as a fraction of two integers. So A over B, right? Where A is an integer and B is an integer. So if I can rewrite all these numbers that you see here from 9 to 24 as a fraction, as a ratio of two integers, we're good. So 32, well, how can I change this so that the top number is an integer and the bottom number is an integer? And it's an integer. So 0.32 is the same thing as 32 around. Pretty easy. 42, 0.42 is again 42 over 100, which you can simplify to whatever, 21 over 50 if you like, and this one was what, 16 over 50 or 8 over 25, but don't matter. Okay, because that enough just proves it that it's a rational number. I'm gonna leave that and I'm just gonna do the easy ones first. So 0.91, 91 over 100. This one, the 5 is in the thousands that place value, and I can just write 17875. Okay, and that's what this is. 0.07 is 7 over 100. 7.75 is 775 over 100. The negatives, it doesn't matter. The 6 is in the 100 point value, and it's just going to be 826, like that. Put a negative. 4.12 is 412 over 100. But negative. 13.006 is 13006 over, and the 6 is in the 1000th place value. 0.525 is 525 over 1000. Again, all these I can write it as a ratio, and of two integers, so therefore it makes it a rational number. Okay. Let's work on some of the other ones. I'm not sure. So let's take a repeating number and let's take number 11. Number 11 is 0.8. So 0.8 repeating, and I'm going to write it over here. It's the same thing as 0.8888 that goes on forever and ever and ever and ever. And ever. So I'm going to say that x equals 0.8. I want to change that to a ratio of two numbers, right? So what did I tell you to do in class? I'm going to multiply, well, there's only one number that repeats, the 8, repeats by itself infinite times, right? So I'm going to multiply that. I'm going to multiply this side by 10, I'm going to multiply this side by 10. I multiply 10 times x, I get 10x. I multiply 0.8 times 10, think about this, and then get multiplied by 10. Multiply by 10 means that this decimal over here is going to move over one to the right. So the final answer would be 8.8. Forever and ever and ever. So that decimal shifted Well, it became 10 times bigger. So 10x, 10 times x is 10x, and 0.8 times 10 is going to give me 8.888888 forever and ever, or just simple bar notation. I'd like you to subtract these two now. If I subtract these two, 10x minus x, if you have 10 x's, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and I remove one of them, you get 9x left over. On this side, if you look at it, the bar notation, a bar notation minus a bar notation, they become 0. That becomes 0, and 8 minus 0 becomes 8. I'm just not going to write the 8.0 because it's not necessary, so I'm just going to write 8. One-step equation from fifth grade, right? You learned this in fifth grade. Divide this side by 9, divide this side by 9. Allows us to simplify that to 1. And x equals 8 over 9. So 0.8 bar notation as a ratio of two integers is written as 8. Let's do 6.3. It's a negative, so I know it's going to be negative. So I'm just going to write that x equals 6. And I'm going to multiply this side by 10, and I'm going to multiply this side by 10 because there's only one number that's repeating. So let me write 6.3 bar notation on this side here. That's what it looks like, right? Forever and ever, blah, 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 blah. If I multiply that by 10, it's going to increase by a factor of 10. So 6.3 times 10 is going to be 63. But this is going to be moving 1 over. So I'm going to get 63.33333 forever and ever, or 63.3 bar notation. That's what happens when I multiply 6.3 by 10. So I'm on the top here, I'm going to write 63.3 bar notation. And 10 times x is 10x. I'm ready to subtract now, right? 10x minus x is 9x. And look what happens when I subtract here. The bar notation 3 and bar notation 3, they become 0, right? So I'm just going to write 0.0. And then I'm going to do some borrowing here. 6 becomes a 5, and then this becomes 13. And 13 minus 6 is a 7. And 5 obviously just comes down. Allow me to get rid of this because I don't need it. Divide both sides by 9. And x equals 57 over 9. So there you go. I wrote negative, right? Sorry, I forgot the negative. So this as a ratio of two integers, negative 57 over 9. Do I have more? Let's do this one, 24. So again, we're going to write that x equals 3.34, which is 3.34. So remember what 3.34 is. It's 3.34, 34, 34, 34, forever and ever and ever, because that's we have two numbers repeating, right? So if there's two numbers repeating, I'm not going to multiply it by 10, but instead I'm going to multiply it by 100. Time this guy by 100, and I'm going to time this side by 100. So 100 times x, 100x. And over here, so again, if we multiply something by 100, if you notice that when we multiply something by 10, that decimal went to the right once. If I multiply by 100, that decimal is going to shift 2 over, so that's going to be not 3.34, but if I shifted one over, it's going to be 334, and then 34, 34, 34. So 3.34. So imagine, well, think about it. 3.34, it's almost 3, right? Let's just round it to the whole number 3. And what's 3 times 100? 300. So 3.34, it's going to be 334 point this bar notation, right? It increases by 100-fold. Let's subtract. Now I can subtract. 100x is minus x is 99x. On the other side, bar notation 34 minus bar notation 34 is just 0. And 334 minus 3 is 329. Nope, 331. What am I doing? Sorry, I don't do that. 331. Divide this by 99. Divide this by 99. These allow simplify to 1. And x equals 331 over 99, 331 over 99. So let me just see. Siri, what's 331 divided by 99? The answer is about 3.34. See? So 3.3434 as a ratio of two integers. It's written this way. Okay. What is that sound? What is next? Do we want to do one more? I can feel that you're highly interested. I'm kidding. Let's do 6.5. You know what? Let's do 6.5. It's the last one I do. Okay. So we're going to write that x equals 6.5 bar notation. And 6.5 bar notation is 6.5555555 forever and ever, right? How many numbers repeat? There's one number that's being repeated infinite times, right? Just a single 5 is being repeated forever and ever. So I'm going to multiply this side by 10. Multiply this side by 10. 10 times x is 10x. Over here, what does it mean to multiply by 10? Imagine if you have $6.50, and if you multiply that by 10, you're going to have about $65, right? So moving this. The decimal moves 1 over, so let me write that whole thing. So if the decimal shifts 1 over, it becomes now 65.5555555. So let me write 65.5555555 forever, or just simply 65 bar notation. Let's subtract 10x minus x is 9x. These 5 bar notation minus 5 bar notation is 0, and 65 minus 6 is 59. Divide both sides by 9. X equals 59 over 9. And once again, you can do it in your calculator, put in 59 divided by 9, and you'll see that you get our answer of 6.5 bar notation. Okay? So that's pretty much what we did today. So we're working with not only just integers, now we want to mixing them all up, decimals, fractions, and it's not going to get any easier. Okay, so I'll stop this now.